If we include all human lives and experiences on the planet, we have millions of years of cumulative knowledge and strategies of how to cope with change. I'm Kristina Douglass, and I'm an archaeologist. My work is primarily about understanding how people in the past dealt with changes in climate and environment. How do people interact with the environment in ways that shape both their communities as well as the environment? And how do they pass on the information that they are gathering for future generations? Madagascar has a very long history of variable climate, and the people who live on Madagascar had to learn how to cope and developed many different strategies to do so. The work really began as an effort to understand how people and now extinct animals once lived together. We used to think that when people arrived on Madagascar, they had an immediate and drastic impact on the plants and animals that lived there before people arrived. But what's interesting is that there's evidence that foraging communities and pastoral communities who rely on the grasslands to feed their cattle and their sheep and their goats have actually had a kind of stabilizing effect on the vegetation scapes of the region. Those communities have co-evolved with these landscapes, and their livelihoods are a part of how these landscapes now function. While we have traditionally focused in our work on understanding what the past conditions were, now we're trying to understand how did communities 500 years ago transmit information over the past 500 years? How are contemporary communities dealing with both opportunities in the landscape and also barriers to successfully sustaining their families and their communities? The more we can understand about how societies evolved and coped with environmental and climate change in the past, the more we can draw from that knowledge today as we navigate change in the present and in the future.